Learning medicine is hard work. Osmosis makes it easy. It takes your lectures and notes to create a personalized study plan with exclusive videos, practice questions, and flashcards, and so much more. Try it free today.
Human rhinovirus, or HRV, is a communicable infectious virus that causes inflammation of the nasal mucosa, or rhinitis. It mainly causes upper respiratory tract infections, and it gets its rhino name, meaning nose, because it commonly causes a runny nose, nasal congestion, and sneezing, as well as a sore throat and cough. There are over 100 serologic known types, and all of them can cause a common cold in humans. Now, rhinovirus belongs to the PICORNAVIRIDAE family of viruses. They are naked viruses, about 30 nanometers in diameter, and they're surrounded by an icosahedral capsid, which is a spherical protein shell made up of 20 equilateral triangular faces. And they're naked because the capsid isn't covered by a lipid membrane. They're also single-stranded, positive-sense, ribonucleic acid, or RNA, viruses. This means that their RNA is actually mRNA, which the host cell ribosomes use to make viral proteins. Unlike other picornaviruses, rhinoviruses are acid labile. That means they can be destroyed by stomach acid, so they don't typically infect the GI tract and don't spread through a fecal to oral route. On the other hand, rhinoviruses do commonly infect the epithelium of the respiratory mucosa, which lines the nasal cavity. So, rhinovirus transmission occurs through contact with infected respiratory secretions, like snot and aerosols, particularly from nose blowing or sneezing. Touching an infected surface, like a door handle, or shaking hands, and then touching an uninfected respiratory mucosa is a main way to transfer an infection. That's because rhinoviruses can survive up to 2 hours on the skin and 4 days on surfaces. Once rhinovirus has been introduced to the respiratory mucosa, it targets cell surface receptors expressed at the surface of nasal epithelial cells. Rhinoviruses can target a few specific receptors for entry, but one in particular is intercellular adhesion molecule 1, or ICAM-1. This attachment allows for rhinovirus to be eaten, or endocytosed, into the host cell. During the endocytosis process, the icosahedral capsid breaks open, allowing the single-stranded RNA of rhinovirus to gain access to the host cell cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, the host cell ribosomes take over viral protein production, helping the virus replicate. Now, when the host cell realizes it's been infected, it releases pro-inflammatory proteins, like cytokines and chemokines, to activate and attract immune cells to the site of infection, and recruit even more immune cells from blood vessels in the lamina propria, the layer just under the epithelium in the respiratory mucosa, and the end result is local inflammation. Rhinovirus infections can occur in any individual, but there are some groups who are more susceptible, like young children, the elderly, and individuals who are immunocompromised, or have underlying respiratory diseases like chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, asthma, or cystic fibrosis. The symptoms of a rhinovirus infection are actually those often associated with the common cold. Symptoms usually begin about 1 to 2 days after infection and can last for about 2 weeks. Typically, they include nasal congestion and irritation, which can mean a runny nose, sneezing, pressure in the head that results in headaches or sinus, ear or facial pressure, or a loss of smell and taste. But they can also include fatigue, malaise or loss of appetite, and other symptoms of an upper respiratory infection, like a sore or irritated throat, a cough, or hoarseness. And while symptoms are usually mild, factors like age, immunocompromised states, and underlying respiratory diseases can result in much more drastic and sometimes even more complicated, life-threatening symptoms. Rhinovirus is mainly diagnosed clinically, especially when common cold symptoms are present without additional complications, concerning physical findings, or relevant medical history. A definitive diagnosis can be made with PCR testing of cultures from nasal secretions or washings. But this is typically only done in more complex cases, like if an individual is immunocompromised or has that underlying respiratory disease. Now, because rhinovirus infections tend to be mild and self-limited, treatment typically centers on relieving symptoms and preventing other people from becoming infected. So, common symptom relievers include rest, hydration, and age-appropriate over-the-counter medications, like first-generation antihistamines, NSAIDs, and nasal decongestants. And general precautions should be taken to limit spreading the virus, including covering coughs and sneezes, thorough hand washing, especially after nose blowing, and regular disinfecting of surfaces. Alright, so to recap, rhinovirus is a type of picornavirus, which is the leading cause of the common cold. It infects the epithelium of the respiratory mucosa, typically through a nasal route of transmission. A consequence of the inflammatory response from immune cells leads to rhinitis, and the hallmark symptoms of the common cold, including runny nose, nasal congestion, and sneezing. A clinical diagnosis is usually made, and treatment tends to center on symptom relief and preventing the spread of infection to others.
Thanks for watching. If you're interested in a deeper dive on this topic, take a look at osmosis.org, where we have flashcards, questions, and other awesome tools to help you learn medicine.